To ease the pressure of school fees on parents, officials from the Equal Opportunities Commission want school fees increment, especially by private schools, to be regulated by the government. Cox Ojukwu, the head of legal department at the Equal Opportunities Commission, observed that school fees currently charged by government-aided and private schools is discriminatory and denies an equal opportunity to every citizen to attain the highest education standards.
The idea is that our children must go to schools. They must not be marginalized due to constant increases of school fees. Now, how do we regulate this? We cannot just do it by way of empty recommendations, but we have to consult with these various stakeholders, including the Parliament of Uganda, including the cabinet itself, and of course, as I said, by reviewing the current policies that govern education in this country, and the legislations, the current legislations, and perhaps to make recommendations for amendments of the law so that we ensure there is no further marginalization of our children, and we ensure that there is universal education for all our children.
These officials also called upon the Ministry of Education to expedite the enactment of the statutory regulations to control fees payable by various schools, preferably before the reopening of schools for the first term.
Talking about, I can sample you with a school like King's College Budo. It's a government school, and this is in the fees before 2022 was 1.26 million. At the beginning of 2002, it was 1.8 million. And at the beginning of next year, 2023, it is 2.5 million. From 1.2 to 1.8 now, next year, so many schools that have levied fees. So we have a mandate, we have the Act mandates us to enforce. And all our recommendations, most of them have been enforced. Most of our recommendations have been enforced. And we know that this, the Minister of Education will come up and enforce it.
Relatedly, the Equal Opportunities Commission is working on an open welcome of all ethnic minorities in the country so that their rights are not abused. They raised the concern during a news conference at Uganda Media Center in Kampala today.
The people called the Benet. You know, the Benets are in the highlands of Elgon. They're being pushed out, their properties or whatever. They are forced to use, you know, the local cultures, and they want their identity. So actually, just to answer your question, I see an open actually welcome to all ethnic minorities. I think when you read, is it article 32? Which talks about, when the constitution enumerates the people, the categories of people who are marginalized, talks about women, persons with disabilities, ethnic minorities, so they are recognized.
Uganda's population is made up of various ethnic groups, and of recent, more minorities have emerged. Report by Jaliet Namwaya for the news.